Hello students and welcome to my online biology classes. Me, I'm Sanjay sir. As you have already know that we have started a chapter called as PUC second year, chapter number 14, ecosystem. We have already studied some of the basic concepts introducing this chapter and some of the structure and functionality of the ecosystem. Some processes like decomposition also. Today, we will be studying two topics. Topic number one, that is food chain and food web. Topic number two, as the trophic levels. Someone might ask a question that why to study two topics in one of the main video. The reason is that to explain these two topics or to explain any one of the topic, these two are interlinked in their explanations. So I thought to add both of the topics in between and to explain them. So let's get started with our explanation of the topic number one. The first topic will be trophic levels. Remember, in the course of study of ecology, I have mentioned many a times that each and every organism in this ecosystem or in this universe has got stages in it. We, the human beings, also under stages. All the organisms are under the categories, depending upon their own variety of characteristics. It may be a herbivorous animal, which is a vegetarian animal, or it may be a carnivorous animal or the non-vegetarian animal. Whatever the organism it may be, all those organisms are dependent on one of the chief source of energy, and that is plants. So in the entire world, highest production of plants takes place with respect to terrestrial organisms are concerned. These are the sources from which the energy is being transferred from one organism to another organism. So the transfer of energy and their analysis of this energy entering into different organisms can be represented in case of stages. If it is a herbivorous animal, it can be categorized. If it is a non-vegetarian organism, then also it can be categorized. Look at the diagram I have given behind me. This diagram explains us the presence of different organisms in our nature. Let me take an example here. So first thing is that with respect to sunlight, the plants utilize the sunlight, that radiant energy, and convert that radiant energy into usable photosynthetic energy. Or in simple terms, they prepare their own food for their growth and development. We for sure fact know that these organisms are called as autotrophs because they produce their own food for their growth and development. So the life starts from the living organisms such as plants in all the concerns. The plants have got highest category of respect in its planet Earth. So the energy or the mass or the total content biomass will be present in the plant body. So the cycle starts now. Since majority of the organisms eat the plants, will keep plants in the bottom section because the basic source of energy starts from here only. After that, from the figure, observe the figure, there are rabbits. So these rabbits are called as the vegetarian organisms, one, or they are called as herbivores. That is the organisms which can eat only the plants, or they can also called as the primary consumers. Remember, I'm mentioning some of the easiest and important matters. Those organisms which can prepare their own food for their growth and development, they are called as producers, such as plants. And those organisms which feed on or which eat only the plants, they are called as consumers. In this particular diagram, I have taken the example of a rabbit. Since the rabbit is vegetarian and eats only the plants, This is called as the herbivorous section, and this is called as primary consumer level, wherein which organisms eat only the plants. I hope you are understanding. Going to the next level, see the diagram. There are snakes, and these snakes, for their growth and development, they depend on 1. Plants, 2. Other organisms. Now, we know for a fact that the snakes are not at all vegetarian in nature. They are completely non-vegetarian in nature, and they feed on other organisms. Remember, section 1 was plants, section 2 was vegetarian organisms, section 3 is non-vegetarian section, wherein which organisms feed on herbivorous organisms. Are you understanding, sir? Right? So snakes eat rabbit. So snakes are also called as heterotrophs in nature, and they are also called as secondary consumers in nature. Remember, primary consumers are, in general, they are called as vegetarian or herbivorous in nature, and secondary consumers, in general, they are called as non-vegetarian or carnivorous in nature. Both are heterotrophs only. Now, from the diagram, you can once again observe there is an eagle or hawk. This eagle can eat snakes and can eat rabbits. But right now, we'll consider by taking this example that they eat snakes. They are also heterotrophs, and they also depend on other organisms for their growth and development. They cannot produce their own food. So those organisms who feed on secondary consumers are called as tertiary consumers. I hope you are getting it. So these organisms have got the energy, have got the potentiality greater than the secondary consumers. Now, dear students, can you see the pattern here? I have made stages of organisms depending upon their feeding habit and production of their own food or the energy transfer habit. Now you can easily understand that I can represent this in a pyramid-like shape or a structure, wherein which I have made the shapes, structures, stages, hierarchy, etc., etc. Here I am trying to explain that the chief organizers of this society or the ecosystem or the biosphere, plants, because from the plants only there are organisms which are dependent on it, and they are called as herbivores, and from the herbivores only there are organisms which are dependent on them called as carnivores, and from the carnivores only there are dependent organisms called as predators or the final tertiary consumers. So the energy or the biomass transfers takes place from this or from like this. Now these stages are called as levels, and in case of ecology, these are called as trophic levels. I repeat once again, trophic levels contain 3, 4, 5 sections on it, which always starts from the producers, in general, I'm saying. And these producers transfer their section into primary consumers. Consumers are those organisms which are not at all independent, they are dependent on other organisms for their growth and development. After that, primary to secondary, secondary to tertiary, and the process goes on. But the chain or the representation of food and energy is like this. So, what do you mean by the trophic level? In the ecosystem, every organism, each and every organism of this planet Earth holds a position. It may be a producer position, it may be a primary consumer position, it may be secondary consumer position, or it may be tertiary consumer position. That position, that particular fixed position, is called as trophic level. In some of the cases, it may overlap. That we'll discuss in future. And when the organisms were at the stage of consumers, primary, secondary, tertiary, they hold a particular biomass, and that particular biomass is called as standing crop. I repeat, if I am talking about vegetarian organisms with respect to the grass, I'm not saying by taking an example of only the rabbit here. There are so many organisms which can eat up these grasses or the plants. So that particular section of herbivores or the vegetarian organisms or primary consumers is called as the standing crop, because they are holding a particular biomass at that particular section. You can even go for the secondary consumers, where in which a lot of carnivorous organisms are there and their group is there, and that particular biomass is called as the standing crop. And if you further go in case of the tertiary consumers also, they have got variety of predators feeding on the secondary consumers, and that is also called as the standing crop. I hope you are understanding these concepts, students, because these are all very basic in nature. You just have to have a little graphic representation only. And this standing crop represents the amount of biomass which is present in that area. I'm not saying if the grasses are present and we have to consider those grasses of the entire earth. No. If I am taking grass of geographical area A, then the number of primary consumers, secondary consumers and tertiary consumers holds a biomass ratio, and that itself is called as a standing crop. So standing crop is the biomass ratio with respect to that particular area or a specific area. I have even given one of the photo also. Try to look at it, you'll get an idea. Here I have divided the entire explanation into one of the photo. Don't worry, it is already taken from the NCERT textbooks only. Here they have said that the primary producers or the chief producers are the plants as a first trophic level, giving the examples of plants. Next, that section entered into second thing called as the primary consumers. They have mentioned that one as the second trophic level, and for that also they have given some examples. Then they entered into third section called as the secondary consumers, mentioned them as the third trophic level organisms, and they have given some of the examples to that section also. And finally they have given the tertiary consumers, they mentioned it as the fourth trophic level and gave some of the examples. Like this, in the ecosystem, it may be aquatic ecosystem, terrestrial ecosystem or variety of different ecosystems, we can say that this is the stage or this is the hierarchy or this is the pattern by which the organisms feed on different organisms, or this is the style, and this representation is called as the trophic levels. Now let us enter into the next topic called as food chain. This is the most basic line of our ecosystem or ecology, food chain. We may be vegetarian or non-vegetarian organisms, we are all dependent on this food chain only. The flow of energy takes place like this only. So the first thing, as I explained in case of trophic levels, is that the first chief producers, the energy which is gained, produced from the producers, should be transferred to other organisms, and that transferring nature, the mode of transfer of energy from the producers to the top consumers or tertiary consumers or the predators, is called as food chain. Because this is not only one organism here, from grass to top producers. No, from the producers, it enters into primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer, or the topmost consumer. So series of organisms are present. Once again, I repeat, the mode of transfer of energy which is produced by the plants or the producers to the topmost consumers through a series of organisms in between is called as the food chain. You can see the example here. I have given an example which explains us a simplest food chain in our ecosystem. I have taken grass as the first producer level, chief producer, first trophic level. After that, this grass is being eaten by one of the primary consumer called as the grasshopper. Now, this primary consumer grasshopper is being eaten by one of the bird, and that bird is called as the third trophic level or the secondary consumer, and from the secondary consumer, that particular bird is being eaten by a snake called as the tertiary consumer or fourth trophic level, and from that particular snake, that being eaten by an eagle, that is called as the predator or topmost consumer. Can you understand the figure, students? It's very simplistic in nature. I have explained the process from the grass, grasshopper, bird, snake, owl. Grass is a producer and owl is the topmost consumer. So the energy transferred from grass to the owl through a series of organisms in between. This is called as food chain. Now from the diagram itself or from the photos itself, we can observe one thing, that each and every organism holds only one position in case of food chain. Remember this, this is important. In case of food chain, an organism holds only one position. It may be producer position, it may be primary consumer position, secondary consumer position, tertiary consumer position or predator position, any one of it. Anyone. It does not mean that it will acquire primary and secondary both also, or secondary or tertiary both also, or tertiary or predator both also. No. Any organism in case of food chain holds only one position at a time. Point number three here to be considered, as the flow of energy can be easily calculated because this is restricted to a particular area and particular time and particular space. Now, it is the simplest chain. This much amount of grass is being eaten by these many number of grasshoppers, and these many number of grasshoppers being eaten by these many variety or number of birds, and these many number of birds being eaten by these many number of snakes, and the process goes to the final content, that is owl. So it can be easily calculated, since this is only one chain, one way, one directional, one flow of energy situation. So the flow of energy can be easily calculated here. As I mentioned, I did not give any other explanations here because the grasses can also be eaten by some other organisms also. I have taken an example, a simple example, that grasses is being eaten by grasshopper only. So I can say that this is a single unidirectional explanation. When I say that grass being eaten by grasshopper and a rabbit and some other organisms, it won't be a food chain, because in my explanation I said so, that in every trophic level only one organism holds the position. So it is always, the flow of energy is always unidirectional, and the line shows a straight line, so that the flow of energy, we can understand it very clearly, right? And here we can say that the competition to feed on other organisms will be very limited, because we are concentrating only on one type of or one directional, unidirectional food chain. So in case of a food chain, the competition will be limited. It is restricted. It is very less with the members of same trophic levels. Easy, right? Okay, students. Let us go to another topic called as food web. Here we don't see only one food chain. Here the interaction or flow of energy, which is represented by the food chain, can be taken in several ways. So different food chains constitute a food web. Different, remember, variety of food chains which are interlinked or interconnected gives us the explanation of food web. Try to observe the photo here. In my previous explanation, I gave you only one type of food chain. Now you are understanding that along with that food chain, some other food chains are also there. As I told you that the grass is being eaten by rabbit, that is also one food chain. Grass is being eaten by grasshopper, that is also one food chain. Grass is being eaten by a mite, that is also one of the food chain. Grass is being eaten by the deer, that is also one of the food chain. So when these 3, 4, 5, 6 are different variety of food chains which are interlinked, gives us the food web. So what is food web? Food web is nothing but the series of food chains which are interconnected, gives us the broad meaning of food web, because it gives us a web-like pattern. Simple, right? So from the diagram, you can easily observe here. Now in this diagram, you can see that there is one explanation called as one organism can hold more than one position. You can observe it very clearly from this thing. Go to the upper diagram and the lower diagram. In both the diagrams, I have given the first basic thing, that is chief producers or the producers as the plants, taking an example of grass. Everyone done, sir. So producers level done. Go to the next section called as the primary consumers. So in the primary consumers, I have kept grasshopper on top and onto the bottom also. So primary consumers lower. Go to the next section, that is called as secondary consumers. In secondary consumers, I have added bird and a bird done. go to the next trophic level, that is the tertiary level, wherein which I have added snake on the topper diagram and a frog upper diagram, because it's not making any unnecessary explanation, right? The upper diagram is also correct and the lower diagram is also correct, okay? Because frogs can also eat birds in some of the cases. There are different dangerous frogs are there, you can believe it, because this happens in the ecosystem. Frog is being eaten by a snake, snake is being eaten by an eagle or an owl or a hawk. Done. So you see that the producer level remains the same, primary consumer remains the same, secondary consumer remains the same, but the tertiary consumer changed. In the above diagram, there was a snake at the tertiary consumer level. And in the final or the bottom diagram, I can say that the snake is at the predator level or top consumer level. So in case of food web, an organism might change their position, right? They can enter into primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer, top consumer, or vice versa, or up and above takes place. So these are the basic things that you have to understand, dear students. That's why I mentioned that an organism in case of food web can hold more than one position. He may be, or it may be, or she may be, in case of primary consumer too, they can shift to the secondary consumer also, and from secondary consumers they can shift it to tertiary also, or vice versa, up and above takes place. Let's go to next point of food web. Since this is very interconnected and holds many food chains, it's quite not possible or difficult to calculate the flow of energy, because we particularly don't know how actually the energy flown into other organisms, because one organism is holding more than one positions, and that organism's is being eaten by secondary or tertiary or the predator, we seriously don't know. So that's why here, since majority of food chains are interconnected, it's quite difficult to calculate the flow of energy. And from the diagram itself, you can easily observe that in case of food chain, we used to get a straight line unidirectional flow of energy. But here, so many food chains are connected, we can say that here the food web contains branched chains or series of diversified chains. It's not a single unidirectional chain, it's a branched chain. And most important thing, that in case of food chain, the computation was limited to the certain members of that same trophic level organisms, because that organism holded only one trophic level. But here the organisms are showing diversified natures of being secondary and tertiary and predator natures. Here the competition is quite large from the same trophic level and to the different trophic level organisms also. Why? Rat can easily be being eaten by the snake, and it can easily be being eaten by the eagle, and it can once again easily being eaten by the owl also. So we are quite sure that the race or the competition is between primary, secondary, tertiary, predator, or different sections or up and above sections. In our textbooks, we can say that there is a table which explains us the differences between food chain and food web. Pause the video in between and try to see the differences between food chain and food web. I have already explained so much. From the 1 minute pausing of this video, you can easily understand what I actually was talking about. Let's enter into another basic thing, another important thing, and that is types of food chain. Remember, students, this is also one of the basics and one of the easiest and one of the important topic of this section, that is types of food chain. In case of food chain, we find two types of categories, and the first one is grazing food chain and another one is detritus food chain. Grazing food chain has got its own explanation but contains trophic levels. Detritus food chain also got its own explanation and contains its own trophic levels. Both should not have to start from producers taking plants an example is not mandatory here. That's why there are differences in explanation of these food chain. Let us go to the individual analysis of these food chains. Observe the diagram. Until this time, whatever that I explained, everything comes in this type of food chain. This food chain is called as grazing food chain. This chain also starts from the producers but by the plants. So in case of the grazing food chain, The chain starts from the plants as the producers. Remember this thing. Plants as producers as first trophic level in case of grazing food chain. The chain starts like this. Plants utilize sunlight and produce food undergoing photosynthesis, and they are called as producers here. And since I have explained in many other videos, since a lot of energy is needed by the plant for its own metabolic activities, less amount of energy transfers from the producers to consumers of varieties, primary, secondary, tertiary, predator level, etc., etc. And more important thing, since we are talking about plants, the energy for doing the photosynthesis or producing the food comes from the sun. I mentioned 3 points here. Grazing food chain starts from plants by considering them as the producers or the first trophic level. Point number two, the energy transfer will be less from plants to other organisms or consumers. Point number three, the energy is being taken from the sun or the chief source of energy to do the photosynthesis, since we are considering the plants, is the sun. Do not forget it. Now here is the twist. This is called as detritus food chain. Here also producers are there, consumers are there, including primary, secondary, tertiary, etc., etc. But instead of plants, we see detrivores, we see decomposers, we see bacteria, we see fungus. No plants here. This chain starts when the organism dies. Remember, when the organism dies, that should have to undergo decomposition. Check out my previous video, you'll understand. So when the organism dies, it undergoes the decomposition, and to do the decomposition, we need decomposers compulsorily. Okay, so this chain starts by taking the first trophic level as saprotrophs, saprophytes, decomposers, etc., etc. Remember this. From the diagram, you can easily observe this. It starts from the detritus. What do you mean by detritus? I mentioned in previous video only. Detritus is nothing but dead leaves, animal remains, fecal matter of the organisms, etc., etc. So the transfer of energy takes place from these decomposers. Since the dead organism contains so many nutrients in it, so much of energy in it, there was no need to do any kind of metabolic energy or metabolic activity in their bodies. It's already dead, so too much amount of energy is being produced and utilized. So much of energy is being present in that body, the decomposers can easily feed on it and grabs up whole amount of energy and big amount of energy, and that energy can be transferred to next trophic levels. So as comparing to grazing food chain, here good amount, best amount, higher amount of the energy is being transferred from one trophic level to another trophic level. In case of the grazing food chain GFC, wherein the source of energy was the sun, here the source of energy is the organic matter or the detritus. Don't forget about it. 3 points. Point number one, here the chief source materials, organisms, or the producers here are the decomposers or saprophytes or saprotrophs. The chain starts from these organisms. Point number two, that the big amount, larger amount of energy is being flown from the one trophic level to another trophic level. Point number three, here the chief source of energy is from the organic matter or the detritus. Don't forget. Another important thing asked in many of NEET exams and theory questions also, sir, is that the members of grazing food chain are interlinked to detritus food chain? Are you serious, sir? Since both of the chains are different, is there any possibility that the members of these trophic levels and those trophic levels are interconnected? Yes, of course. Why not? I'm saying plants and bacteria, plants and fungus, these are not interconnected. Okay. Next thing, the rat, grasshopper, rabbit, the primary consumers. Considering here woodlouse or some other mites, termites, insects, right? They might be interconnected, right? These are also called as trophic levels. These are also trophic levels. This is also called as first one. This is also called as first one. When you enter into the second trophic levels of the grazing food chain, you can take the example of birds. Here also you can add the birds as an example, because birds can also eat mites, right, sir? So there are so many explanations, but these chains are interlinked with respect to trophic levels, right?
please do not forget it. With respect to trophic levels, with respect to transfer of energy, one organism might be interlinked in both of these chains, like this, trophic levels. Dear students, I hope you understood my video relating to two topics, trophic levels and food chain and food web. This is the end of these topics. I'll meet you in my next video taking another topic, that is a promise. Until that time, like my videos, share my videos, subscribe to my channel. Till that time, God bless you all. Take care.